We're back.
We're back again. It's your host, YYZ Highlights, Jamal Williams. Peace and love. I'm here with my videographer and cohort and... That's that guy, man, Esquire. Another segment, the first one was sell off, and now we're back again. Someone that is well-respected within the community, none other than the founder of Toronto Revelers and former...
Toronto Raptors.
Former Toronto Raptors center, Mr.
That dude is tall. Let's just get that out of the way from now.
On location at his event, his third annual event, Christmas Fete. For all those that don't know what a fete is, Esquire, because you have a psychology. Explain what a fete is, please, so people know what a fete is.
When you talk about high energy, when you talk about jump up, when you talk about rags in the air, when you talk about powder, that's usually the heights of a fete. But at the same time, there's different dimensions that come along too. With Jamal's Christmas Fete, that was a little bit more, I would say more high scale, more high end.
Caribbean urban.
Yeah, it was Caribbean urban. That's the best way to describe it. People were actually coming through looking proper. They actually were, and a lot of times they were dressed to the nines. There was one dude, what was that suit that one dude was wearing? The one that was actually inside the hat? I just saw Sgt. Pepper's, like, I just got thrown back to the Beatles when I saw this guy. It was a great event. It was almost like a very, very intimate vibe, to say the least.
The women were beautiful. The one that posted for the pictures that we posted via Facebook, were really engaged in having us showcase them having fun at Jamal's event.
That's
in my opinion. Right? The dancing was done up at a fete. Usually there's a lot of whining. However, it was a really nice mix of music.
The energy inside the place was still high. The fact alone that they shut off the music, and I think it was just like 5 minutes where Renzi was trying to cut it down. All I know is just that DLC played one track, and quite literally Brenton ran from the far bar straight back up to the DJ booth, and I tell you, Brenton's the energy was still there.
So you couldn't miss him. I really enjoyed myself. I had a good time. A lot of times when you see me, especially if I'm working, doing media, like, you know what I mean? I'm really focused on the media, but at the end of the night, I actually got to, you know, let my locks down and have a good time.
You still had me working. That's all I know. This was supposed to be a business partnership. This dude is all tunning up and allowing me to take pictures and everything. Yo, Esquire, come and take this 1-2-2 pic. I'm like, yo.
That's why the video is how it is. You were kind of following me. You're following, you know.
No, I realize this. I recognize this. But still, every once in a while, a dude can try to put down a camera and try to bubble on a ting. I'm just saying.
Look at the pictures and you see how Esquire was doing. Some of the best looking women in the party.
Hey, I took one shot, but I think that's all I needed.
Let's go to Jamal's, his dedication to Toronto.
Yeah.
He actually attended the Toronto Raptors game that night and made sure that, because he was a former ambassador.
Yes.
I know someone else, I think Drake now is an ambassador for the Raptors.
Right.
He's a former ambassador, and he went to the game, supported Toronto, and then came to his event. And still turns out, since he started with a t-shirt mask, going into the costume, he's definitely been leading it, in my opinion. The children's band that he has been winning titles year after year after year. If you guys don't know, look it up. Year after year after year, these guys were knocking it out. Again, 2 times road match champion. His parents are Caribbean. They're from Trinidad and Tobago.
Yep.
Right? But he found it really important to...
Let's pause it for a second. We need to get this out here from now, just in case you didn't realize this man is a proud Trini.
Soca to the world, I am.
The red, white, and black is just bleeding through this guy's veins. That's all I know. As a Bajan, I can respect that. I'm just saying that again. He has these moments where he just has that moment. Sorry, go ahead.
Every opportunity I get, I'm gonna rip the culture. Before he got in there, he started beating brass right away.
That's true.
He hit the rhythm.
That was impressive. I know for a fact it was a little bit of a challenge because he had to stand all the way up.
His mother, who has been an integral part of his career for his entire life and his career and his business ventures and whatnot, was there. The elders were there in support. His father was there, Garth, the Marion, his mother, elders in the community, Marion Telesford, as well as other people that have really been there to make the costumes and make sure everything goes good at the mass camps and throughout the entire carnival season.
And the fact alone that he continuously, in his own way, gives back to the community.
Scarborough Walk of Fame, charity events, the basketball camp that he runs every year. He gives away a charity thing for kids.
Honestly, it's admirable as far as what McClure has been able to accomplish.
He loves Toronto, he loves the city, and he loves the cultures, and he says it's very important to give back to the people that support him, because without us, he wouldn't be doing what he's doing.
I mean, I'm looking forward to seeing what Toronto Revelers has in store for 2014.
Yeah, so am I.
You look forward to that time of year to be able to see that on display. Well, I guess that's just about it for us.
Yeah.
So again, shout out Toronto Revelers. Shout out Jamal McGlure. Thank you so much for having us and allowing us to cover your event.
And this has been a YYZ Highlights exclusive with your boy Jamal Williams and
Esquire.
Stay tuned for more.
All I know is just that the one shot that I had to do with the 50 mil with Jamel standing beside Jamal, I got to post that up inside the video as well. Just so that way you could see the heights that he has to go through. You ever heard of the movie The Air Up There? That's exactly what it came. That's exactly how it came out. That's, I just had to put that in.
It was a bit awkward for me because I kept speaking right into his nipple. So it was slightly awkward for me.
Wow. Okay. We just took it to a completely different level.